No sunshine, I'm feeling better. Watch them all scatter each other. If your daddy did.
And it's been called any number of names through the years, but now it's Sun Life Stadium, the home to the Dolphins. Dolphins for the extra point. Extra point is good. And the kicker's ready to go. They'll take it at the 20. The Buccaneers have seen this game just get away from them as it continues to get worse. They've still got more than a quarter to play.
Well, look, it's been a good learning experience, and you realize how tough this game is. So learn what you're doing here in this last bit of the game and see if you can carry that over into your next contest.
Winston's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Evans had it but couldn't hold on as this goes incomplete.
Evans is going to go back to the huddle and look at all his teammates and go, my bad. Well, they know it's your bad. Everybody, even the offensive linemen, they saw you were open and you dropped.
Second down and 10. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle.
In a situation like this, third long, if you're the defense, catch him by surprise and blitz.
Third down on the way. Sims is in the backfield. And that incompletion is going to bring us to a very quick fourth down.
We still have more than a quarter to play here, Phil, but this defense shows no signs of wearing down.
I think we're surprised by this, really. We didn't expect them to just dominate all day long, and so far it has been total domination.
Let's see what he can do here. Fights through that hit. He's in the clear. In stride, and he's home for the touchdown.
Special team, so important in the NFL game, no doubt about it. How about that? The punt returner catches it. All the good moves, breaks some tackles, and takes it all away for a touchdown.
The Dolphins with the PAT to come. And the point after is good. The Dolphins getting set to kick it away. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Dolphins have displayed a phenomenal defense here today, and I think you would agree, Phil, that's the reason they're in position to win this game.
Yeah, the defense has been incredible. So aggressive, so full of emotion, running around. Every time you see a tackle, there's like seven guys on the defensive side about the ball carrier. So that's awesome defense. That's why they're winning this game here so far today. I guess you'd say he's like a quarterback. You can't complete them all. And this running back, he can't make every run spectacular. Nowhere to go, so only gets a couple yards this time.
And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. The Buccaneers lined up. Everybody split out wide. Winston standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Looking middle that time, and it's incomplete. Third down and six.
The chances of giving up the big play are pretty high, but the rush, they're quick enough. They get there, and they sack the QB.
He's going to try and return this one. Barrels ahead and picks up maybe three or four. When one quarterback plays well and the other doesn't, that can lead to a pretty one-sided affair like we've had here today.
Yeah, it has been one-sided, but look, there's always reasons why a quarterback plays well or doesn't, Jim. It truly is a team game on the offensive side, and the good numbers come from the offensive line that played well, and the bad numbers come from an offensive line that really struggled here today.
First down at the 37. And the give to Lamar Miller. Running room. Going to take it the distance. The 10. Going to take it home for the touchdown.
You don't see a lot of them anymore because we have so many good tackling safeties in the NFL. But not this time. That long run goes for a touchdown. It was about the moves and the blocks down the field. Terrific job by the offense.
The Dolphins now will tack on the extra point. Driving extra point is good. The Dolphins are ready to kick it away. Across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Dolphins played a rugged first half, Phil, and have kept the pressure on since halftime.
I'm going to give a lot of credit to the coaches for this. They have kept the pressure on, like you said. They know their players are into the game plan, and they are making the right calls.
First down at the 21. They'll run it here. Takes the hit and is brought down. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
He didn't get many yards that time on that run, but he's had a terrific day. When there's an opportunity to get some yards, he's been there to take advantage of it.
Winston's going to take it from the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. Can't find the target on the pass underneath.
Man, the quarterback, the coaches, his teammates, everybody loves to see a player get. type of effort. How about the receiver just going all out to make the catch? Doesn't quite get there, but the effort is outstanding.
The Buccaneers will line up. The first down marker right at the 31-yard line. The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 25. And that'll probably go as a drop.
Safarian Jenkins is unable to bring that pass in, Jim. He just took his eyes off the football. And when you do that, it's usually going to result in a drop. But those things happen. It's not a perfect game. You've got to overcome adversity. I think this guy will do it. Next time it comes his way, he'll make the catch.
Looking to make a difference. Tackle down right around the 47. That return's good for about 24.
The Dolphins love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
Miller's not been the bell cow we're accustomed to seeing out there. This offense has been going to the air, and it has been effective.
You know, I don't know anything about a bell cow. What does that mean? Is that what you are? You a bell cow?
That's the lead cow. That's the guy you put out front.
You lead the herd?
And everybody else follows.
Yes, okay. Well, today is not his day, but when his time comes, I know he'll be the guy.
Next time we go to a production meeting, I'm going to put a bell around your neck. I'm going to follow.
Around my neck?
Yeah, you'll be the bell cow.
Oh, okay. A bell.
First down here after the run. Double tight end formation. It's Miller. Muscles through the defender. The Dolphins have had a great rushing attack all game, Phil. Miller's been leading the charge on this front, Phil.
And they've done it many ways. They've done it with power runs, going outside, going inside, draw plays. Everything is working for this running game today, and it's been impressive to watch.
First and 10. Incomplete. Burner was in the vicinity.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
The ball sits at the 12-yard line. Miller's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. The catch is made by Cameron. The next snap will come from the 2-yard line. Three-step drop. What a catch. Touchdown. This game is really out of hand now. Still just the third quarter, but I think we're close to being able to put this one in the books.
Oh, yeah. Get that OW column and put a slash underneath them because they have won the game, and they deserve to win, Jim, with their enthusiasm, the emotion they have shown in playing such. solid football.
The Dolphins getting set for the kickoff. No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. The Buccaneers hope to get things going. They have been anything but productive here in quite some time. Three consecutive drives that have led to nowhere.
Well, let's give a lot of credit to the defensive side, especially the defensive line. They are absolutely taking it to the offense. They are beating them up, and the defensive line is winning the battles like this. It's all about the defense.
The Buccaneers offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Loss of a couple that time. Second down and 12. Doug Martin. They'll mark the football at the 22.
Martin's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
After that run, third and 8 for the offense. Winston's got it in the gun. Vincent Jackson on the deep throw. The Buccaneers will punt the football away. He wants to return this one. He's taken down at the 47. That return's good for about 22.
The Dolphins know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking. They get it done.
Miller's lined up in a single back formation. Tannehill's on the move. Brings it in. The Dolphins get a first down.
Tick, 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 tick. That's what we're trying to do. Make that clock keep running down. You got the offense out there. You got a big lead in the second half. Every first down you get shortens that football game.
Ryan Tannehill will be under center. Tannehill's dropping back to throw once again. And they can't connect.
Fourth quarter and a blowout. Let's see if we can get this game over in a hurry.
Wow, you don't have to say it that way. I'm anxious to see how this game ends up and how they play it out. I want to see a team that has some pride, and even though they're getting blown out, to stay in there and keep fighting.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. Easy catch there. No one near him. The catches have come in bunches for this wide receiver, Phil.
Good job on this wide out today. He is finding a way to catch the football, but let's also give credit to the offensive line for pass protection and the coaching staff. They have done a tremendous job of coming up with different plays to find different ways for him to catch the football.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Now slashing to the right side, looking for room.
The Dolphins, they believe in their offense. They know once they get inside the red zone, they can run or throw. That time they run the football, and it picks up some good solid yards. Great job by the offensive line.
Lamar Miller with the carry. That's a gain of 7.
Hey, look, it's not the offense's job here late in the game. You're up big, you're near the goal line to just kneel on it. You keep running your offense, run the football. It's up to the defense to stop you.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. They need to get the playoff. Offense a little too slow getting set at the line on that one.
Delay of game, offense. Still first down.
Stepping up to the line at the 6-yard line. First and goal from the 6. They'll run with it again. Another touchdown to increase the lead. And that just adds to what would.
Already going to be a lopsided victory.
Well, you and I have done a few lopsided wins, but this one will be right at the top of the list and right from the very start. You know, we heard it from the coaches. They had a lot of confidence in their team today, and boy, their team came out. They were sharp, and they got it done.
It's good. The Dolphins getting ready to kick it away. He's got a chance to return this one. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Buccaneers got absolutely nothing out of their previous possession. And here they are back on the field. Another 3-and-out, I would have to think, would be very demoralizing to this team right now, Phil.
Yeah, it's going to be demoralizing to the offense, but I'll tell you who's going to be more demoralized is the defense, because they need to sit on the sidelines and get a little rest. So I know there's a lot of pressure on this offense right now.
Martin is in the backfield. The Buccaneers have it at the 24. Trying to find his target over the middle, but that pass goes incomplete.
Well, but it's third and long. I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
The Dolphins sat at the line. Dime package. Winston's back in shotgun formation. The pass falls incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series.
Well, Phil, as you like to say, lesser announcing teams might point to that old cliche, winning all three phases of the football game, blah, blah, blah. Thankfully, we're above that. But I think you'd have to say it applies to the proceedings here so far.
Well, we think we're above a lot of things, no question, Jim. But you're right, the defense has been great, and it's no cliche.
He'll have a chance for a return. Jenkins is there to make the tackle. That return's good for about 26.
The Dolphins love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
When one quarterback plays well and the other doesn't, that can lead to a pretty one-sided affair like we've had here today.
Yeah, it has been one-sided, but look, there's always reasons why a quarterback plays well or doesn't, Jim. It truly is a team game on the offensive side, and the good numbers come from the offensive line that played well, and the bad numbers come from an offensive line that really struggled here today.
Tannehill's got two tight ends on the field for this snap, and it's complete to Cameron. The Dolphins are in front thanks to their quarterback. Tannehill's been unstoppable so far.
He has been unstoppable, hasn't he? And when your quarterback is hot, keep giving the football to him. They've done it, and he has rewarded the coaches.
Moving it to the other side of the field at the 49. Second and six. Throws the pass. Pulls it in. Gains 20.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down. And that's what you want to do. Take your time. Look at the play clock. Take it down as low as you can and keep picking up those first downs.
Tannehill's completion percentage 70% on the day.
Ready, blue, 10, go.
The Dolphins have it at the 29. Looks but can't connect on the short throw.
Got to give the secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
They bring in the extra tight end. The Dolphins have it at the 29. Tannehill's pass will be incomplete this time.
Look up at that scoreboard. You're leading the football game, so we have a third and long situation. So you've got to know that. Manage the game. Don't take a chance.
It's Tannehill out of the pistol.
Ready,
the Dolphins have it at the 29. And he hauls it in.
Good job by the defense, staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle, and now we have fourth down coming up.
The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play. And the give to Lamar Miller. Carter's there that time for the tackle.
First down by the offense inside the red zone. Can the defense show them something different here and keep them from scoring a touchdown?
coming up to the line. The 13.
Blue 10.
First down and 10. It's Miller.
Well, I'll tell you, it's getting ugly out here.
The rest of this quarter is simply a formality.
It's what it looks like, and it just looks like, hey, that doesn't look like it. It is. This game is absolutely over. There's no such thing as a miracle that's going to pull this out for the losing team. But give the offense a lot of credit. On the winning side, they have been sharp all day long.
Lined up now in kickoff formation. They're setting up the return. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Buccaneers offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know, the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sidelines. So the sense of urgency is there. You should be fired up, and I expect a better drive this time.
Second and 10. And that pass is just thrown away. On the way, third down. The Dolphins with a nickel look here on defense. Dropping back now into the shotgun. Looking across the middle. And it's going to be tackled. And that's going to bring us to fourth down. Yet another drive here, Phil, that's going to end up with nothing. And maybe you start to worry about things getting a little chippy, because that is one frustrated offensive unit you're looking at right now coming off the field.
Nah, they won't get chippy, Jim. They're not tough enough to get chippy and start a little fight with the other team. They've shown all day long they're scared of the opposition. They've played terrible, and that's why they're losing.
And a run back of about 12. The Dolphins are enjoying a dominant time here as they've stretched their lead out with three straight scoring drives and showing no signs of slowing down anytime soon.
As I watch this team, I sure don't see them slowing down. It's just everything they're doing has been right on both sides of the ball. And when it's going like this, take advantage of it and try to keep it going.
A foot race to the end zone. The 10 taking it all the way home for the touchdown. Fourth, and they continue to keep the pedal to the metal.
Oh, absolutely. The offensive coordinator, he wants to pad the stats of his offense. Keep putting up those numbers and total yards and watch them rise in the rankings. And, hey, sometimes you got to do that, is do what's good for the offensive coach.
Ready to step up and send this one down to the end zone. They bring him to the turf. And a run back of about 18. The Buccaneers offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen. Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest. That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
From the shotgun, he'll throw it over the middle. Over the middle, and incomplete that time.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, The effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
Winston's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Pulls it in. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. This drive pretty symptomatic of the way things have gone all day long, Phil. Another failed third down conversion. And another sequence that ends with the offense trudging off the field.
No answers on the offensive side here today. And, yeah, I'm going to give the defense a lot of credit. They've been outstanding, but the offense just hasn't tested them enough with different plays to make them think on the defensive side.
Fights off the hit. Tackle down at the 42-yard line. Player is down on the field, and the training staff comes out, and we'll step aside for just a moment. Two tight ends on the field here. First down at the 42. It's caught by Matthews. The Dolphins have come up with some big plays in the passing game. And Matthews has had big plays all over this field today, Phil.
He's like the shooting guard, Jim, in basketball. If he's making a lot of shots, let him keep shooting. So they have found a way to keep getting the football in his hands.
Puts a hand. Oh, he... Touchdown, Dolphins. And Matthews, his second touchdown of the game. Could have said this in the first quarter instead of waiting until midway through the fourth, but this game is over.
It is. Yeah, the way you said it is, there's a finality to it, no question. And the losing end, the coaches, the players, they got to go back. They got to do a lot of soul searching because this was one pitiful effort.
Makes the PAT. Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini.
Guys, I just spoke with a Dolphins official. They wouldn't specifically say what the injury was other than it's an upper body injury that won't stop him from returning. Back to you.
And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. The Buccaneers offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players. And
Vernon gets to the quarterback.
This might not be nice to see, but every once in a while it's kind of fun to watch the quarterback get sacked like that. Good job by the defensive end.
Loss of four on the play. The Buccaneers from the 22 throws the pass. Middle of the field and incomplete this time. This is third down. Winston standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. It's intercepted! It's not getting any better for the offense here late in this game, as now they get picked off.
The frustration and the bad play just continues, and you know, it's so bad, the coach can't even yell at the players. All you can do is pat them on the head and encourage them to keep trying.
The Dolphins offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. I mean, you got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
That's a gain of six. The Dolphins have really been able to run the ball today, and it's been a huge reason why they lead. Miller's been brilliant, and he's shown no reason to stop giving him the football.
Well, it's working well. Don't stop. The running game is hot. The offensive linemen feel the power. They love it. Just keep running right at them.
Tannehill gives it up. tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
Miller's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
The Dolphins approach the line, and they're going with their jumbo package.
And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run. This game is over.
Oh, listen, it's been over for a while, and I just question, why are you still trying to score? Have a little mercy. I know it's pro football, and I don't usually say this, but the game has been decided. Have some mercy on your opponent and just try to get this game over.
Miller's taking it. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. The Dolphins now ready to kick the football down the field. He'll have a chance to take off. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Buccaneers are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better. You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play.
Second down and 7. And incomplete.
Well, your teammates are really going to respect you after something like this. Anytime you're on that field as an athlete, and when you give all your effort to every single play like that time, how about that? Just giving every bit of effort he can to make the catch, not able to get it, but what a job and effort.
Third down and 7. It was right there, but he didn't bring it in. Phil, this offense hanging its head in disappointment as they have been able to generate nothing as far as energy converting to yards.
Jim, it's just been a bad day all around on the offensive side. You know, the offensive coordinator, he had a bad day. The quarterback, the offensive line, spare no one. They've all been awful.
He's going to try and return this punt. Fights through contact. And they bring him down at the 38-yard line.
You got to be tough and aggressive as a punt returner in this league. That time, what a good job. Catch it. Get right up the field. Nice yardage.
The Buccaneers defense comes onto the field after surrendering a touchdown on the last drive.
Well, they're hoping for better results. No question about that, Jim. They got to come out. They got to hustle. There was not enough hustle last time. And the number one key for all defensive teams is play hard.
Way to call them out there, partner.
Hey, that's what I do. I like to call people out. The Buccaneers defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. And they tackle the runner for a loss.
This will be second down. Miller's lined up as the single back. This play will hold up. He's inbounds. The Dolphins continue to pass the football. And when they have, they've looked in one familiar direction. And Matthews has been the top target, and he's been very strong in this game.
The offense, what a tremendous design they've had here today. They've had many ways to get this football to the wide receiver, and he has done a good job of taking advantage of it.
Makes the catch.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Tannehill's completion percentage 70% on the day.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Almost intercepted.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets in position, down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. After a short delay, now they'll run it. And that's David in on the stop.
Miller's trying to be patient. But there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
It's third down coming up. Sims is going to secure the handoff. He'll pick up seven this time. The offense is still on the field right now. Fourth down, and they'll need to pick up two. Dropping back three. No stopping them now. That's a touchdown. Impressive showing today. And it's almost on the brink of running up the score and creating some bad blood. What do you think, Phil?
Who cares, man? Rub it in, baby. Rub it in. When you're on top and you're winning the game, I say go for it. Rub some salt in that wound and let them know how much it hurts.
Dolphins for the extra point. The point after is good. Tannehill certainly given his team some momentum with that scoring drive. He just put together a possession where he threw for more than 60 yards. The Dolphins setting up for the kickoff. And he'll start his return. Tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Buccaneers offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Well, Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard so you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling.
The Dolphins with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Takes it from the gun. Here we have second down. Yeah.
Martins ready to run off to the screen. Brought down at the 26.
I know you won't believe this, but sometimes completing a short pass like that does give a quarterback confidence, so it does serve a purpose.
Offense still looking for a first after that completion on second down.
Here we go.
Winston's going to take it from the gun. They're in punting formation. Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20.
The Dolphins offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
First down at the 20. Incomplete.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
The Buccaneers lined up in the nickel.
Set, wide 20. Wide 20.
Second down and 10. Kenny Stills has the reception.
Sometimes they tell the receiver just to go long, run a fly route, run a nine route, because that means straight ahead or a streak. Show the speed that you have and get it done.
First down at the 38. Miller's got it. Screen play. Breaks free. Breaks out of that one. No one's going to get him now. The 10 all the way home and all alone. Touchdown. That could be construed as running up the score, Phil. This game was already in the bag.
Well, Jim, it could be construed. You got to try a little harder or the score will get run up on you. How about that? You know, you are allowed to stop them on the defensive side, and you got to put some effort into it and some heart, and we've seen neither.
He made it. Tannehill is going to have a tough time upstaging what he did on that scoring drive, passing for over 80 yards against a defense that had no answers for him. The Dolphins now getting ready to kick it away. Tackle's made. That return's good for about 18. Rashad Jones marching back onto the field now. And he and all the other players on that unit can give themselves a big pat on the back for what's been a fantastic, dominant effort today, Phil.
Absolutely. Pat yourself on the back. They should. They hustled from start to finish. And to me, that was the difference in the game.
First down at the 17. They go screen with Martin. And Jones in on the tackle.
Well, it's not quite a first down, but a good read, good throw, good catch. Well, a lot of good there, isn't it, Jim? But nice job by the offense. Now they got second and short. Look out. Who knows what the next play is going to be.
The Buccaneers take it from the 23. Almost intercepted that time. So after that last incompletion, it is third and 3. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Evans has got the catch and the first. Third catch today so far.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
2 minutes to go before this one's in the books. Just 2 minutes left of this one. We're back now for the end of the fourth quarter. The Dolphins' defense now is going to go nickel. First down at the 37. Looking across the middle. Second down following that incompletion. Martin lines up in the backfield. Just a quick drop back. And there's a drop.
Safarian Jenkins is not able to come up with the catch. And a lot of times when you see a receiver drop a pass, they take their eyes off it. That's one thing. Or they're just trying to get it in your hands too quick. Why? Because they're trying to make some yards after the catch. That was the problem that time.
Winston's got it in the gun. Stands in the pocket. They bring back out the offense to go for it. The Dolphins defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Snap it out of the gun. Ball is out. He's brought down. Phil, can you believe how untimely a fumble we just saw?
Jim, I cannot believe it. Here's why. Because you know in a situation like this, the first thought in your mind is you can't fumble the ball, and they did anyway.
The Dolphins offense takes the field, and what is in essence an encore bow to the crowd here as they have been the dominant team all game long. And time is running out.
This is when I was at my best when I played, Jim. When we were winning, I came out there late in the game too. I can
balls loose.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second down and five. Keeps his legs moving. They score again here to pad the lead. My goodness, Phil, there's certainly not a whole lot of sportsmanship down on the field right now.
Yeah, this is getting to a point where even I'm starting to feel bad for the losing team, and maybe it is time to call off the proverbial dog and let this game just finish a little bit more mercifully.
The Dolphins ready to kick it away. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Dolphins have victory within their reach now, and they've only turned up the heat as we've gotten into the fourth quarter, Phil.
And, you know, listen, they're doing this against a very good offense, so that makes it even more impressive to play this well against a good offense. What an outstanding day by the defense.
Here we go.
First down at the 21. This goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle. From the gun. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle. Following Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Buccaneers will line up. The first down markers right at the 31-yard line. Winston's back in shotgun formation. Looking middle that time, and it's incomplete.
The Buccaneers don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
They're set to punt it away now. Going to try his luck here. He steps out.
The Dolphins know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking. They get it done.
Here's Levante David, ready to lead this defense back into action. And it has not been an easy day for him or anyone else on that defense, really. They've been knocked around pretty severely.
Yep, Jim, it was all their fault. There's no doubt about it. They got beat physically. They made a lot of dumb mistakes. If you do those two things together, you're going to lose the game.
That receiver, Phil, is a quarterback's dream. Going high in the air on a high throw and getting the reception.
Oh, man, do quarterbacks love that? They throw it and think, oh, my gosh, that's bad. They're ready to chase the defender down with an interception. But no, the wide receiver goes up and just makes an awesome catch.
Tannehill's, and that's a touchdown late in this one. Impressive showing today, and it's almost on the brink of running up the score and creating some bad blood. What do you think, Phil?
Who cares, man? Rub it in, baby. Rub it in. When you're on top and you're winning the game, I say go for it. Rub some salt in that wound and let them know how much it hurts.
The Dolphins ready here for the kickoff. He'll take it from the one. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Buccaneers come out now with little time left on the clock, and they've got to be thinking, what could have been here today, partner?
Yeah, that's it. You know, Jim, these are tough moments, and what you do in a situation like this, don't throw any more gasoline on the fire. If you're the quarterback, don't take a chance and throw a silly interception that people are going to talk about. Ball's out.
And it's a takeaway. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
What a deflating play for the offense. The defense picks up the fumble, takes it not only for a touchdown, but how long? Look at the blocks. That makes the offense lose its confidence. They're going to have a hard time coming back out on the field and making it happen.
Inside of the uprights. Ready to swing his leg as aggressively as possible and send the football down to the end zone. Fields the football at the 3. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Buccaneers offense comes onto the field for a last play or two before this one's over. There's nothing they can do now to pull this one out, Phil.
Yeah, it's very tough to even get the courage or the energy to finish this game off in a situation like this because it's so disappointing. And I say to them, don't take any chances. Don't get hit again and just get off the field.
Well, the lights were bright and the team was up for the occasion here, winning in prime time.
Nothing like it, man. Winning in prime time. When you know it's all about you, and I've said many times, today's football players, they love being on the big stage. Well, they were today, and they got it done.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA,